Yo, what's up guys? It's your Andrew. Welcome back to another Roblox stream. It's Jaylen's Games. Today, we're reviewing Pokemon Red Rocks. Dramatic intro. And, just for the record, this is a very long game. Not only did it take a long time, but it also takes a long time to play. As for the format that we started in our earlier Murder Mystery 2 review, I'm going to be doing the same thing, starting with the summary, the pros, the cons, and finally, my rating and then my take on whether you should play it or not. So, let's get straight into the summary. Okay, so Pokemon Red Bronze is, it's based on the world of Pokemon, and basically, what you can do is, so usually what you do is that you explore, you collect Pokemon, you battle trainers, in general, have a good time, and do stuff like that. But also, Pokemon Red Bronze also has some special features that let you battle the people in the Battle Coliseum and trade the Pokemon with other people in the trainers. So, I believe that's good for our summary of Pokemon Red Bronze. It's actually a pretty simple game to start. So, at this point, let's get straight into the pros. Okay, so the first thing I think is really good about it is that it has a really good storyline. Like, the story of the beginning is actually really exciting and really, not like weird in a bad way, but like special. Like, it's a really good story in general. So that's one of the pros. Another thing is, this game actually takes long. This game is a pretty long game. It's not gonna be a one day or two day thing. This at the very least will take days. Quite easily going into weeks to do. Because there are hundreds of Pokemon and there are 8 gyms and like there's so much exploring to do. And it's actually not like a short game, it's a really long game. I guess that's it for the pros. Moving on to the cons. When you start the storyline, even though it is an interesting one, it can be boring to some, and it takes a long time for the action to really start picking up. Another thing is that also, I'm on PC, but I'm using a touchscreen, is that you can't actually move using the keyboard. Or WASD, or, arrow keys. You have to use touchscreen, which is a big minus, because if you don't have, touchscreen compatible devices, you may not be able to play this game. Another thing is, some of these do need Wi-Fi, like the Battle Coliseum and the Trade Resort. Also, another pro that I forgot to mention is that the interface is really stylish. It's a really developed game, in my opinion. And with that being said, let's move on to the rating. If I were to rate this game, taking fully of all the pros and cons, and also taking in all the beautiful scenery, because the sun is actually really realistic, I would rate this a 7 out of 10. This game is actually a really fun game. Once the game starts picking you up and once you spend some time in it, however, things, like major setbacks, like the fact that you have to use touchscreen and the fact that you need Wi-Fi to play it, really sets the game back from 8 or 9. So, I think 7 out of 10 is a good compromise. And with that, we can answer the question, should you play it or not? I think, personally, if you can't devote the time to doing this, you probably shouldn't be playing it. Because this game is not an easy, it's pretty easy, but it's not like a quick game. You will have to actually spend time if you want to get anywhere in this game. I think if you're willing to put in the effort, you definitely should play this game. If you haven't played this game before, it's a good one. It's not like a crappy game. It's an actual quality game that is pretty good if you can actually spend time with it. So guys, thanks for watching this Roblox review of JMX Games. I'll see you guys next time. Remember to like and subscribe, and if you want to see me review another Roblox game, make sure retirement down